gathered together, especially to remember loved ones and friends who died in Waterloo. Let us place into God's hands all our thoughts and all our prayers this night. And so, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred rituals, we call to mind us. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who will that your only begotten Son, having conquered death, should pass over into the realm of heaven, grant, we pray, to your departed servants, that with the mortality of this life overcome, they may gaze eternally on you, their Creator and Redeemer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you. Your brother Jesus said to her, will rise again. Martha said, I know you will rise again in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Yes, Lord, she said. I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who has come into this world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Died and gone to God. We trust that they are given in a few moments. In a few moments, we'll be invited just to come forward and to light a candle, remembering those who wish to remember this night. As we gather together at this time, as I mentioned, let us place all those into the hands of God. Eternal rest grant unto them all.
Let perpetual light shine on them. May they rest in peace.
Amen. May their souls and all the souls of the faithful depart.
Through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen. We sing together. Amen. power for truth, the world's flagship.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy then we begin, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have had the word to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. For John Boyd McDonough, whose anniversary occurs at this time, for Barney Finney, who passed away recently in New York, and all who have died in your mercies, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
So his command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
"Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil."
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the Son of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but when you say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ. 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 Thank you. Through these sacrificial gifts which we have received, O Lord, bestow on your departed servants your great mercy, and to those who have endowed with the grace of baptism, grant also the fullness of eternal joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just to mention that the candles that we have lit will remain in now until they run out of fuel. Just so that our thoughts and prayers are very safe. Don't worry, the church won't burn out. And also, I read this